but know that this is true. Every young man wants to see the beauty come shine through. I'd like to tell you a story of a young girl that I knew. She was determined to make it, but her resources were few. Thank God for good people who come along and lend a helping hand. They come and stand tall, strong and free, and the whole world to understand. Young minds matter. You have to know that this is true. Every young mind.
Every young and welcome to the 15th Anniversary Torch Awards. Please be seated. It is my honor to present this year's 2019 honorees, who stand on the shoulders of our ancestors, such as Nelson Mandela, Harriet Tubman, and Alvin Ailey, and will inspire our next generation of heroes and sheroes. Please hold your applause until the end. Andre Farr, receiving the Visionary Award, escorted by Torchette Kaylin Campbell. Michael and Maddie McFadden-Lawson, receiving the President's Public Service Award, escorted by Torchettes Malia Williams and Alaysia Virgil. Quentin E. Primo III, receiving the Living Legend Award, escorted by Torchette Tori Carter. Wendy Raquel Robinson, receiving the Spirit of Dance Award, escorted by Torchette Thamar Scripio. Please give them a round of applause. And now, a performance by NAACP award-winning program, Amazing Grace Conservatory. When words are insufficient, they dance.
is for us. Peace and quiet and open air. It waits for us somewhere.
To welcome to the stage someone who has been empowering the community through leadership of young women for more than 15 years. I remember the first Legacy Ladies Torch Awards. I remember the growth that it's experienced over the years, and it's amazing. Under her leadership, she has changed the lives of so many families and has given the disenfranchised a new vision. She leads with drive, determination, dedication, and endless energy. I'm going to pause. This isn't in the prompter. You see, the devil's a liar. The devil will tell you this can't be done. The devil will tell you that it's too much energy. You're too busy. You don't have time to help other people. The devil is a liar. Jackie doesn't listen to that individual, if you will. All right, please put your hands together for the one and only Lady Jacqueline Castillo.
Fantastic. Let's give him a round of applause. Woo. And I want to extend a special thank you to all of you, because this celebration would not have been possible without you and the grace of God. So I want to thank the Brotherhood Crusade, the Castillo Charitable Foundation, Citibank, Arno Hackett, LA Lakers Youth Foundation, LA Speech and Language Therapy Center, Ann and Tim McCallion, Morgan Stanley, Capri Capital, William and Jennifer Shack, Southwest Airlines, Tory Banks, United Parcel Service, and U.S. Bank. And also our friends who have traveled from coast to coast to be with us this evening. And I'd like for them to stand as I call their names. From Jacksonville, Florida, Karen and Hugo Donaldson. And my second son, Hafen Donaldson. From Stockton, California, Nellie and Oscar Haney. From Dallas, Texas, Ken Jarvis and his lovely daughter, Michelle. From Las Vegas, Nevada, Drs. Rodney Hollifield and Charlene Day. From Sacramento, my beautiful sister, Patsy Wade, and my brother-in-law, Richard Wade. Let's give them all a round of applause. And I wanted to stop there because someone deserves her own space, her own applause, and that's my mother, Leslie McCurson. So I'd like to thank you all for joining us. At this time, I would like to introduce you to our advisory board members who have been supportive of us. They've given their time, their talent, their guidance and resources, and even their money, which we love, to help sustain us for the past 15 years. They will be escorted by the hardworking women of Legacy Ladies. Please hold your applause until they have all been announced. Daryl Brown, escorted by Lady Joycelyn. Jim Castillo, escorted by Lady Amber. Justin Castillo, escorted by Lady Amber. Okay. Okay, they look alike. Jim Castillo, I'm sorry. My better half. Avis, and here comes my best friend, my son, Justin Castillo, escorted by Lady Andrea. Avis Gibson, escorted by Lady Tony. Benita Pilgrim Perkins, escorted by Lady Ann. And I also want to recognize Roberta Jenkins and Jackie Thompson, who are not able to be with us this evening, but have always been there by our side, and I just want to thank them. And now, we would like to thank all of you for your service. Torchettes, would you help me out for just a minute, please? As they come to the stage, here they come, our beautiful torchettes. Each of you are receiving a trophy right at this moment. You can present them with their trophy that says 2019 Torch Awards, presented to each of you for your 15 years of endless service. On behalf of Legacy Ladies, we say thank you. Thank you. Let's give them a round of applause. Thank you so much. Now, please turn your attention to the monitors. Thank you for joining us at our 15th anniversary. Without you, this would not be possible. We appreciate the corporate support. We appreciate the donations, the guidance, and the love that you have given us over the last 15 years. But you know, this journey just did not start. It started back in 2004. There was this burning in my soul, in my gut. I didn't know what it was.
until one day, early Sunday morning, the answer materialized. All of a sudden, in the wee hours on Sunday morning, I started scribbling in the dark on a notepad that I keep at my bedside. I woke up that morning and I looked at it, and of course, you would not be able to make sense of it, but to me, it was a mission statement. It spoke volumes to me and it said, Legacy Ladies Incorporated. The next line said, Torch Awards. I turned and looked up to the sky and said, Yes, Lord. I had answered the call, and at that moment, I knew my life's purpose. It was an exhale moment for me. I had received a calling bigger than myself. There was no room for pride, but a lot of humility. My goal is, and it remains the same, to advance the goal of young girls. Give them a voice. Give them guidance. Give them love, and without judgment. So in June 2004, Legacy Ladies was formed. And the rest? Well, that's history.
One of the hallmarks of the Torch Awards is the recognition of those who have carried the torch of change to an accomplishment throughout their lives.
They are passionate and committed to helping others. And oftentimes, they have multiple roles within the organization to get the job done.
They are motivated by a set of principles and guided by what is the right thing to do.
The Legacy Ladies' DNA consists of love, consists of service. It consists of community outreach. And most importantly, it consists of
They're small in numbers, but they leave a big footprint, as you will see this evening.
And it has always been my goal to lift as I climb.
The wheels of education turn slowly, so we put our foot to the metal with the From the Schoolhouse to the White House leadership program.
It's a labor of love that we share with individual donors, school administrators, educators, and families who provide the ultimate gift of their time and share resources for the betterment of our entire community, which we proudly serve.
The high school students, tremendous inspiration. We're confident in our future when we see these young people.
So legacy is about leaving the door open for those to come behind you.
And battles that we thought we had won, we must fight again. We have work to do. But like our ancestors have said, we ain't no ways tied.
We want them to be energized, to start a movement, to change the world, to become entrepreneurs.
I want you guys to recognize these women truly create a legacy.
We must honor the men and women who have fought so hard for equality.
May they have the hindsight to know where they've been, the foresight to know where they're going, and the insight to know that God Almighty guides this mission.
Legacy Ladies is committed to ensuring equal opportunities, equal education, strengthening families, rebuilding our communities, and closing the achievement gap. In the words of President Barack Obama, leadership tomorrow depends on how we educate our students today.
The Legacy Lady Leadership Program changes this overwhelming statistic one student at a time. Every year, true to their mission, the Legacy Ladies identifies a family to support, to provide encouragement, and offer a helping hand.
We will continue to serve as a catalyst for change by preparing our children for the global marketplace and regain our competitive edge. We must ensure that all children have quality education.
Sisters, you are to be commended, and the founding mother of this organization is to be commended. She proves that the best way to make your dreams come true is to wake up.
Legacy Ladies was formed with six women. I think my wife was one of them. She's not here tonight because it's prom night where we live, all right? So, and I got twin senior prom daughters, so that's the deal. So I know, oh my. Yes, it's an oh my night. But she's with them, holding down the fort. They developed a strategic plan to support historically disenfranchised young African-American women and families. During the past 15 years, they have made the dreams come true for 110 African-American women, young women, to attend college and enhance their educational experience. They have given them scholarships, they have given them laptops, they have given them iPads, they have given them trips from coast to coast so that they can better themselves, and additional financial assistance totaling more than $500,000. And a lot of that's because of your support of this organization. These graduating seniors have participated in their after-school program from the schoolhouse to the White House Leadership Academy. They are the next generation of leaders, and they will be the next Madam C.J. Walker or Sojourner Truth. Now, they have honored and changed the lives of more than 16 families by providing housing, financial assistance, scholarships, vehicles, and equipment for the visually impaired. They have also provided support for military veterans who returned from war and needed a soft hand to change the trajectory of their lives. John Howard, a veteran, held hands with the Legacy Ladies, and his life changed forever. And now, please put your hands together for John Howard as he shares his story.
Good evening, everybody. As you said, my name is John Howard. I'm really excited to be here tonight. Can't stop smiling. This is a very special night for me, myself. In 2012, I was a guest of the Legacy Ladies, but only that time, I was a recipient of Adopt a Family Award. So in 2012, when I met Miss Jackie, I like to say Miss Jackie found me, because I was truly lost at the time. And I was a single dad suffering from traumatic injuries, mental and physical, from an aircraft accident I suffered in the military. And at the time, I was raising a teenage diva who just didn't understand that dad didn't have it at that time, but he was trying so hard and he was really trying to make it. And I had isolated myself for 2 years and no one knew, and I put on such an act. And I just stayed in my house and I went out and I went to school. I had started community college because I didn't know what else to do. And I wanted so dearly to change my life for me and my daughter. And then Miss Jackie came to my life and she says, I see something in you and I'm going to be by your side, and I'm going to see you through this. And I kind of looked at her, and I said, yeah, okay. And then she called me the next day and says, I need you to meet me right here. And I'm saying, wait a minute, I'm still in the bed. And then I learned, when Jackie moves. And you better be ready to move, too. But I went and met Jackie, and she was taking me some places, and we were doing some business, and I was, like, so amazed. And I said, wow, how do you do the things you do? And she just turned and smiled at me like she always smiles. And she said, no doesn't mean no. It just means not right now. And that changed my life. And I've never told Jackie that. So this is the first time she heard it. But it meant a lot more to me than what it seemed. Because to me it meant drive on. Don't have a pity party. Get on your feet. Move forward. And I did. And 5 years later, I graduated from USC with my master's degree in social work and concentration in mental health. And so now I stand here today to share some of my success, which really was based on Jackie's kindness and her empathy and her love. and the love that she shares with everybody, because she gives herself wholly to everyone. And that's something you just don't see every day. And it meant a lot to me and my daughter, and life is great. And today I've started my own nonprofit, one in which I carry out of my own story based on sustainability for veterans who are like me, who were suffering and didn't know which way to turn. And now we create sustainable plans to show them how to retire based off the benefits they earn. And every day, that I get a call from a veteran, I have veterans all the way in Ontario, Canada, and they say, thank you for changing my life. And I turn and I look at the sky and I say, no, thank Jackie for changing my life. And so I just want to say that what you guys do here today goes so much farther than what you understand. Jackie is providing leadership. These children will come out of here and they will go somewhere into their communities and they will become leaders and they'll touch people. And those people will touch other people's. And that's what we need in today's society, is we need to lift and give that, just that little bit of hand that we can give to one another will go such a long way. And it wasn't a money thing that I needed, it was the confidence, and that's what she built in me. She taught me about relationships and trust and meaning. She taught me that when you had somebody in your corner, life was a lot stress-free. It was a lot stressless. She told me I could build my confidence that way, and I did. And now no is not in my it's not even in my vocabulary. I can't even say it because I don't believe in it. And I just want to end in saying thank you, Miss Jackie, for changing my life and many other veterans' life, because you are truly a legacy.
Keisha Nix of the LA Lakers Youth Foundation and 2018 honoree for the Humanitarian Award will pass the torch to Andre Barr. Put your hands together.
Good evening, and thank you. I am here to present the Visionary Award to Mr. Andre Barr. Andre is an entrepreneurial executive of 30 years in the business of sports and entertainment. Andre first gained acclaim as the president and CEO of House of Blues Sports and again as the chairman and CEO of Black Sports Agents Association, also known as the BSAA. For the past 8 years, he has served as the chairman of the City Youth Exposure, whose mission centers around introducing middle school youth to positive, unique, and educational experiences that they would not otherwise be able to experience in their everyday lives. In 2018, Andre launched the Woke Up Movement at the Baldwin Hills Crenshaw Plaza, a call to action for our communities to get civically engaged in national, state, and local elections. His legacy is to influence in the suites and in the streets, to create a positive paradigm shift that will lift our heads, uplift our community, and engage and encourage our next generation to thrive. Now please turn your attention to the monitors.
American thing that you can do is vote. And so to get people civically engaged is really, really so important. And the way that we intend to do it is to make it fun, to make sure that people are getting out and having a really, really, really good time while they're doing something critically important.
Ladies and gentlemen, the 2019 Visionary Award, Mr. Andre Farr, escorted by Kaylin Campbell.
Wow. How amazing is this night? Give it up for Lady Jackie and the entire crew. You know, it's funny, I'm going to share some stuff, just a couple of personal things with you. I am so appreciative of this couple. There are people around the country, they know about the Who's Who, the Lynx, Jack and Jill, but I would trade them all in for Jim and Jackie, okay? I want to thank Darvin Moore from coming all the way from Atlanta with our EMG group, Catrice Massey, Philippe Darrell, Pastor Barrett and family. I'm really so happy to be here tonight at the Torch Awards because, quite frankly, I didn't even tell Jackie this, you know, I haven't been well. I just got released from my doctor's care. I was in the hospital for 21 days, Jackie. So I caught something that's called valley fever. And valley fever is when you breathe in spores from the soil and it gets into you and it makes you feel like you have pneumonia. So for the first 10 days in the hospital, they were treating me with antibiotics thinking I had pneumonia, when really I had valley fever. So I am just blessed and thank God that I'm here, okay? And with that said, Jackie, next year, I am adopting the Torch Awards, and I'm going to give my full effort to make sure that I bring my platform and my vehicles here to support what you're doing for these young women, okay? You know, speaking of Lady Jackie, I was raised by a strong, intelligent, hardworking, God-loving woman. She single-handedly raised three young boys to become successful men who all respect women and love the Lord. You know, I was raised to mind a woman. I'm a big old guy, but I mind women. And to be honest, with all the awards that I received, I wouldn't receive them unless I had this woman in my life who's the president of all of my companies and she runs everything. And it wasn't for her. Her hard work makes me look good. Please stand up, Jay Brown. Stand up, Jay. Stand up. Solid gold. I was awarded the Innovative Entrepreneur Award at the White House with President Obama in 2015. That was an amazing experience for me. But to be honest, to be here at the Torch Awards is even more thrilling, because I feel like I am here with family. I love what I'm seeing with the legacy ladies. Ladies in the room, I know that I've talked to many of you tonight, the young ladies in the program, and you all want to know about success. And the one thing that I can tell you about success is I don't know what the secret is, but I know what the secret to not being successful, and that's trying to please everybody. You have to stay with your passion, and you have to give it to God and allow him to deliver it to you. I made my first $1 million before I was 21. I made my first $10 million before I was 24. And it was all behind listening, because everyone around me was telling me it couldn't be done. But nobody cares what you know until they know that you care. But what I'm here to tell our family, and I feel like we're having a family dinner tonight, is that insolvency is insufficiency. Being insolvent is not sufficient. Reparations is a dead-end situation, like a desert mirage destination. If you're waiting for somebody to give you something, you're going to be waiting until you take your last breath. One thing I do know, more than anything, none of us here are going to get out of here alive. So what counts is what we're doing while we're here. And so I've received a lot of awards in my life. I've been awarded from the White House to the schoolhouse, from the suites to the streets. But none of those awards mean anything because I'm looking to be rewarded by God. So with that said, young ladies, I want to teach you something because, really quick, I know that in this age of social media, there's a lot of negative chat, a lot of talk, a lot of gossip, a lot of bringing you down. I know people who have done some incredible things, and as soon as there's speculation they did anything bad, it's all over everything. But they never talked about all the wonderful things they did. So I want to talk to you really quickly, young ladies, and I hope you're paying attention. This might be a time to take your phone out and record this so you don't forget. There was a young pilot and an old pilot, and they were on the runway, and they were about to take off. And as they're starting to take off, they start to climb. The young pilot hears a hissing in the background. So he looks back, and there was a snake in the cockpit. And he tapped the older pilot. He said, "Sir, sir, there's a snake in the cockpit. We got to land the plane and kill the snake." The old pilot looked over at him and said, "Keep climbing." They get up to 10,000 feet. He starts to see the snake crawl over in between them. And he said, "Sir, look at the snake. It's right here. It's a poisonous snake. We got to land the plane and kill the snake." An old man never looked at the snake. He said, "Son, keep climbing." They got up to 20,000 feet. The snake coiled around, opened his mouth, and was about to strike. And the young man started crying. He said, "Sir, we need to land the plane to kill this snake." And the old man said, "Keep climbing, son." They got up to 30,000 feet. The old man looked over at the young man. He said, "Son, look down." And he looked down, and the snake was dead. He said, "You see, son, snakes can't live at high altitudes. You just keep climbing and they'll take care of themselves." So, legacy ladies, keep climbing. It doesn't matter what anybody says. If God gives it to you, nobody can take it away from you. Okay? And I want you to know, quiet as it's kept and against what the world tries to teach you, there are men here who respect you and will support you. And will put you in position to lead. So I want to thank my other honorees tonight. I want to thank Keisha, first of all, for presenting me. I'd like to thank Wendy Raquel Welsh for coming. Wendy Raquel Robinson, my bad. My buddy's name is Welsh. He wants to marry her. It's a whole nother story. And he's from Richmond, but a whole nother story. And I'd really like to thank Michael and Maddie McFadden Lawson. They are amazing at what they're doing at the Urban League. We had a great meeting with them, a great dinner with them, their gala last week. But most importantly, I want to thank my best friend, Quentin Primo. You guys will see him a little later. He is a great businessman, but he is a great man. And so I'm proud to say that he is my friend, and I thank to share this stage with him. I'd like to thank him. So good night, everybody. I look forward to seeing you all. Thank you.
All right. If we're all together at a future event and I tell that snakes can't live at altitude story, y'all pretend like you haven't heard it, all right? That's how good that was. I'm sure he won't mind. He'll go, wait. All right. I'm really thrilled about this next award. These people, this couple is just plain doing it. That's all I need to say. To present this year's President's Public Service Award is Elliot Hines, first vice chair of the board of the Urban League. Put your fingers up to the moon.
Guys, what y'all trying to do? Good evening, everyone. Good evening, everyone. I'm very pleased to be here. Our chairman, Noel Massey, was unable to attend. He's a former Torch awardee. He had a death in his family. He asked, and the funeral is actually this weekend, and he asked me to stand in, and I could not be happier to present this award to Michael and Maddie Lawson. Michael currently serves as president and CEO of the Los Angeles Urban League. It's one of the oldest and most respected civil rights organizations in the United States and is dedicated to providing economic empowerment, educational opportunities, and the guarantee of civil rights for underserved communities in the Los Angeles area. Boy, are we working hard on that. And prior to Michael's appointment as president and CEO of the Urban League, he was nominated by former President Barack Obama to serve as the United States Ambassador to the Council of the International Civic Aviation Organization. Michael has held positions of significant responsibility on numerous charitable, educational, and administrative boards. And I can say to you personally, as a lawyer who's been practicing here in Los Angeles for almost 25 years, Michael has been a mentor and a leader for many, many, many of us for a long time. We've been looking up to Michael and the example that he has set as a real trailblazer in an extremely difficult, challenging, competitive legal community that is nationwide. Now to Maddie. Maddie is a scholar, philanthropist, a patron of the arts, whose primary goal is to make a difference in the world. Her extensive work in the arts, women's leadership, politics, and political fundraising has established her as a philanthropic force to be reckoned with. Her philanthropic efforts know no borders. Currently, she serves as the president of the MML Group, which specializes in strategic partnerships for her clients in philanthropic advisory services. Recently, Maddie was appointed to the Smithsonian Institution National Museum of African American History and Culture Steering Committee. She was also appointed by former President Barack Obama to serve on the President's Advisory Committee on the Arts Institute. Please turn your attention to the monitors.
Hello, my name is Michael Lawson. I'm the president and CEO of the Los Angeles Urban League. This is a position I've held since November of 2017. I applied for this position mainly because I felt that the Urban League was in need of the leadership that my wife and I could provide. And I say that in that way because we travel as a team. We have been in this city since 1988 when we moved back from New York. But my love of this city goes back further than that, when my family moved here in 1962 from Little Rock, Arkansas. So I've seen the uprisings in the 60s. I've seen the militancy of the late 60s and 70s. I've been through the desegregation wars in the schools. We've dealt with and lived with the brutality of LAPD and the transformation of that relationship. So the future of the Urban League is bright. We are moving the Urban League into the 21st century. We're dealing with, we're training people to become entrepreneurs. We're looking at and trying to fix the access to capital and access to credit that has kept our communities in a state of limbo. We are going to get back into the fight and address that issue along with the other issues that plague our community. And we are going to be successful. Thank you for this gift. Thank you for this honor. Thank you for looking at us and giving us the recognition that we hope will help build and strengthen our community in the future.
Hi, my name is Maddie McFadden-Lawson, and I'm the president of the MML Group, which is a group that focuses on strategic partnerships and philanthropy advisory counseling. I came to the Urban League to join my husband, the president and CEO, to embark on this path to do the work that we need to do for our community and to continue the legacy that the amazing Mr. John Mack established over a period of 35 years. I am delighted to be here. I am grateful for this honor. Thank you, Jackie Castillo. Thank you, Legacy Ladies. I admire you and have tremendous respect for all that you do to make the world a better place and the amazing work that you're doing with these young ladies. So thank you for this honor and this blessing.
Ladies and gentlemen, now Madam Presidents, Public Service Award recipients, Michael and Maddie McFadden-Lawson.
Good evening. This is truly an honor. I want to thank Jackie Castillo and the Legacy Ladies for bestowing this tremendous honor of recognition on us for doing the work that we just feel needs to be done. We have been doing this pretty much since we met. This is our 40th year of marriage. And if we keep it up, I may get it right. But I want to say that I am thankful to Elliot for that gracious introduction, and the board of the Los Angeles Urban League for the support that they are giving us, and the energy that they and everyone in the league provides and works toward. We have a lot of work to do. There are many issues that need to be addressed. And it is so important for us to know that organizations like this are in the fight as well. We cannot do this alone. No organization can do all the things that need to be done, and the things that Jackie Castillo and Legacy Ladies are doing is so vitally important and so critical, and you do it so well. I stand here in awe of the things that you are able to do, and doing it for the 15 years that you've been doing it. Thank you so much for your service. But we are all in this together, and the fight will continue, mainly because we are standing on the shoulders of giants who have been in the fight for so long. Our parents, our grandparents, their parents. This fight has been going on for a long time, and we are winning, but it is still a long way to go. The arc of justice, as Dr. Martin Luther King quoted oftentimes. So we are thankful for this. We appreciate this, and we will continue the fight as we go forward. And thank you very much. Maddie?
Thank you, Elliot, so much for those kind words. I am honored, Jackie. This is such a tremendous honor to bestow upon us, and I cannot say enough about the work that you do and how you're making a difference in the world with the work that you're doing with these young ladies, because we know they are going to go forth and be a tremendous blessing. I want to recognize my husband. Everyone knows we are a team. That's just what we do. And we work together to make a difference. Our benefit is that we are doing this work and not calling attention to ourselves, because the work must be done. And I want to recognize our sons who are here with us tonight. You give us the strength every day to get up and do what we do, and we hope and pray that we have instilled in you to create your own legacy. I want Michael Anderson Lawson Jr. to stand. He's our oldest son. Morehouse Man class of 2005. His brother, Jonathan Scott Lawson, our youngest. Morehouse Man class of 2013. So we are very, very blessed. Unlike Andre, I'm overcoming this cold. The devil is so busy. He or she knew that I had to do this this evening and just got all in my health to prevent me from being here. But I push forward, and that's what I do. I just push through, because life will always throw these challenges, but we have to be strong enough to know that we can march through, and we are not listening to the background noise about what we can and cannot do, because we are a mighty people. We have survived some of the harshest conditions that could come across anyone on this planet, and yet we are still standing. So I want you to know that we hope that we can lock arms and aims with you and do the work that we are currently doing at the Urban League for our community. For my fellow honorees, Andre, what a blessing for all that you're doing. It's amazing. Wendy, what you're doing to just drive the creative spirit and energy in these young kids that you work with on a daily basis, again, without calling attention to yourself. And I think there are times you really feel that you are working on a shoestring budget, but you still get it done because God makes a way. And for Quentin Primo, who is changing the face of what's happening on the economic landscape in the Crenshaw District and beyond, you know, it's an honor to serve with you, and we hope that we can forge, really, a bond whereby we can all work together. And as I stand here, there is one thing that comes to mind, and Jackie, I think of this because of the work that you do and the work that you continue to do, and it's actually a Greek proverb, and it states that you can judge the growth and the progress of society when old men plant trees whose shade they will never enjoy. And we have to get to that place as African Americans of planting trees for which we will never enjoy the shade. We have to do more. We can do more. We must do more. And I thank you again for all that you have done, because we will keep climbing, we will keep reaching, and we want to make sure we're doing the work for this community that will make you proud, and hopefully you will join with us in our efforts so that we can truly make a difference and lift others as we climb. God bless you.
Maddie and Michael Lawson, ladies and gentlemen. Present the Living Legend Award is Carl Dickerson, the 2016 President's Award recipient, who will now pass the torch. Carl.
You know, at nearly 81, it's pretty difficult to get used to a monitor, so I brought old trusty here. You know, having been in business myself for over 55 years, I know how very, very difficult it has been for any person of color to succeed in our economy at the time Quentin got started. So it's a special pleasure to have this honor to present to him today. Quentin E. Primo III is the chairman and chief executive officer of the Chicago-based Capri Capital Partners, LLC, one of the largest minority-owned real estate investment management firms in the United States. Under Quentin's leadership, the mission of Capri Investment Group is to improve overlooked communities in which they are investing in. The Capri Investment Group is at the heart of Baldwin Hills Crenshaw Investment Project. He is also active in civic and charitable organizations, and most notably serves as the chairman of the Primo Center for Women and Children, a transitional shelter serving the homeless. So please turn your attention at this time to the monitors.
First and foremost, I think whatever you do in business, it's very important that you have a higher purpose. We want the communities in which we invest and the world at large to be a better place because we were here. Even though that sounds very trite, very simple, it's something that can really drive results and simply drive motivation. When everybody on your team realizes that it's just not about making money, that it's about improving people's lives, it makes it infinitely more personable, and you get a lot more loyalty, you get a lot of better results. We have a mall out in LA called the Baldwin Hills Crenshaw Plaza, and if we simply managed that mall to make money, it wouldn't be the extraordinary asset that it is now. It's just getting better and better and better because we are actively serving the community, and we're attempting to give the community a better merchandising mix, a better retail shopping experience. We're trying to improve the lives of those that live in the community. And they come and they see the mall and say, geez, we didn't realize this was possible in our community.
Yes.
Well, it is. I think it's critical, especially in new business ventures, that you just simply can't give up. You can never, ever, ever give up, because if you're not in the game, you can't win it.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, the Living Legend Award recipient, Mr. Quentin Primo III.
Thank you, Carl, for that eloquent introduction. Not deserving, but I greatly appreciate it. And thank you, Toy, as a torchette for escorting me up to the podium here to address all of you. I would certainly first very much like to thank Jackie and her board of Legacy Ladies for bestowing this award on me and for all the extraordinary work that you do in the community that has been clearly defined this evening. We thank you so very much for your commitment to our community. Secondly, I'd like to acknowledge how extraordinary it is to be recognized by a group of individuals as wonderful as Legacy Ladies, and to be acknowledged with a group of honorees that are accomplished, are leaders, are people that we look up to, that I look up to personally. Three of which are my dear friends, Andre Farr, and Michael and Maddie Lawson. So it's wonderful to be here with them. What Jackie and Legacy Ladies do in the community, as I said, is just really to be greatly appreciated and to be acknowledged itself. Clearly, the programs that they are, leadership programs that they have organized and are executing, are changing lives. Jackie, like I, believe that changing simply one life is an accomplishment. And she goes about her business at changing one life at a time, changing one family at a time, and changing one community at a time. And at the Primo Center for Women and Children, we believe in the same philosophy, that you simply don't have to focus on everything and everybody, but just focus on one and another and then another. And you can certainly change the world in that activity. Jackie is clearly a woman of faith, and she does her work in the name of the Lord. My father was a Episcopal priest, and we grew up in a very religious household. Thinking of how Jackie and Legacy Ladies are the work that they do is so impactful, and it's in the name of the Lord and in great faith. It reminded me, as I was preparing to speak to you this evening, of Scripture. And one of my favorite verses is in Matthew 25, verses 31 through 46. And in it, it talks about on the last day the Lord brings about the righteous, and he puts the righteous on his right hand. He says, "You righteous, I'm putting you there because you fed me when I was hungry, and you gave me drink when I was thirsty, and you clothed me when I was naked, and you visited upon me when I was sick, and you came to see me when I was in prison, and that's why you sit on the right hand." And one of the righteous said to the Lord, "But Lord, I don't remember doing these things to you." And he responded, "Well, just as you did it to the least of my brethren, you did it to me." So I really believe that what Jackie and the Legs Ladies are doing, the selfless acts, the commitment to the community, our community, their tireless efforts on our behalf, lifts all of us up, are to be extraordinarily commended. And again, it is my great honor to be acknowledged this evening. Thank you very much.
All right, here we go. Love this woman. I was a reporter in the field, and she was so nice to me when I first came to LA 18 years ago. She was a big-time city council member. I love her still. Saw her tonight, nothing but love. Please put your hands together for Jan Perry.
This girl is on fire.
Of the Infrastructure Funding Alliance and the 2012 recipient of the Lifetime Achievement Award, and she will now pass the torch to Wendy Raquel Robinson.
Good evening, everybody. Award-winning actress, philanthropist, co-founder, and artistic director of Amazing Grace Conservatory is known for portraying groundbreaking roles as ambitious leading women on television. Her passion for educating youth interested in the performing arts allowed her and the late Tracy Coley to create a platform for youth to express themselves. Established in 1997, Amazing Grace Conservatory has grown from 75 students to over 300 students annually, to thousands since inception. You can clap even more for that. Her mission for Amazing Grace Conservatory is to train and develop emerging artists and at-risk youth in the performing arts. This year, her artistic talent will bring to life Mrs. P in a new role on the ABC's bold, provocative new drama, Grand Hotel. Give her another applause. Please turn your attention to the monitors.
Amazing Grace Conservatory is a performing arts school for youth and young adults ages 5 to 18, whereas we teach acting, voice, dance, media arts, creative writing, spoken word, yoga. But beyond the arts classes, this is a haven where young people can express themselves just freely and fully without judgment. They become better human beings. We develop confidence and self-esteem through self-expression. When you love what you do, it's not work, it's a purpose. And when you wake up excited about coming here and seeing the looks on those young people after they take their bow, it's like that's when you see the purpose is greater than you, it's far greater than you, but it's all in line with the passion because I love doing what I do.
Conservatory is amazing. I've been to all the performances and these children are like professionals.
I think it's such an inspiration to see that there's a place that young people can come and really study the arts. I'm so proud and I love Wendy, so this is just a wonderful thing.
Our next honoree has used her voice to speak out and make us laugh over 20 years in memorable roles. When the veteran actor started Amazing Grace Conservatory in 1996, she honored her first love of theater and vowed to give back to her community. The Amazing Grace Conservatory has provided theatrical training in acting, voice, dance to 350 students annually.
Gentlemen, and now Wendy Raquel Robinson, recipient of the Spirit of Dance Award. Please welcome her to the stage.
First of all, I want to acknowledge this young lady because I was nervous backstage. And she started coaching me. She's like, it's okay. You all right. You do this all the time. You do this on TV. Just breathe. You got this. Just breathe. So, Famar, thank you. So crazy. Yes, I do this all the time, but you know, to be last in an award and receiving it. And thank you so much, Ms. Jackie Castillo. But wow, we got some heavy hitters in the room. I mean, you know, I've never been to the White House. I got a picture with, you know, President Obama. But I do. But I am just so inspired by the honorees. And I am so humbled by the work that you do, the Lawson family, Andre, Mr. DePrimo, thank you. I want to start with, and I had to say my mantra, and I want to say it to myself, and I want to speak to the Torchette, the young ladies. Because our deepest fear is not that we're inadequate. Our deepest fear is that we are powerful beyond measure. And it is our light, not our darkness, that separates us, because we ask ourselves, who am I to be brilliant, talented, and gorgeous? But Thamar, and to all the young ladies, who are you not to be, because you are a child of God, and there's no need in shrinking so that others don't feel insecure around you. So I've had a very interesting week, and I want to start with the Torchettes. They came over to Amazing Grace Conservatory, all the young ladies, and it was for a taste of AGC. And we gave them a sprinkle of acting, a sprinkle of spoken word, a sprinkle of music class. And when I say those young ladies not only inspired me, but our staff and our village, it was just so amazing to see the leadership in these young ladies. I want to acknowledge Ashley. She's one of the Torchettes as well, because she left. She was like, she didn't want to come take class. She was like, now how can I get a job here? That was the first thing she asked. So, Legacy ladies, you are doing something that is so phenomenal, and not only building these young ladies, but creating the leaders for tomorrow. So I applaud all the work that you were doing, and thank you so much. Who knew that 22 years later, Amazing Grace Conservatory would be this, I call it, it's a saving grace. The arts saved my life. I grew up in South Central Los Angeles. I went to Washington High School. I graduated from there. Shout out to Dr. Bird, Principal of Washington, who is here. Where are you, Dr. Bird? I know you, all the way in the back in the cheap seat. I see you, girl. That's my girl. But we were song leaders together. She was a cheerleader. I was a song leader there, and now she's principal. So we stayed right there where it is. And I applaud you, and I thank you so much for not only having me do classes there, but we're all together. I want to acknowledge my village of instructors, of family, of friends, of artists that have poured not only into the lives of so many young people, but you give so tirelessly in a nonprofit business that sometimes there are no thank yous. We don't get to take those bows. So if you guys could please help me in recognizing our managing director, our acting instructor, Ms. Kim, well, our managing director, Gigi Bolden, Kim Bailey, our acting instructor, Mr. Stefan Terry is in the house, our music director. Thank you. I have parents that have not only had children matriculate through our program, but they are still there, and they are still giving back tirelessly. So we have Melissa Ali in the house, one of our OG parents. And then I have to acknowledge Ms. Renee Washington, who dropped my name in the hat for this award, but she's an alumni parent as well. Thank you so much, Renee, for everything that you do. And I want to talk about my journey, but I'll be very, very quick because I don't believe in coincidences. And it's amazing that this is the Torch Awards, because I feel like this has been the year of the torch for me. As you saw in the clip, Marla Gibbs, I worked for Marla Gibbs as a dance instructor. So go figure, I'm getting the Spirit of Dance Award. I started as a dancer. And I was teaching dance classes in South Central forever after I graduated from college. And just know, as long as you go to school and you become an expert in your field, there is nothing you cannot do, right? So I couldn't get an agent, I couldn't get a manager, I couldn't get a return phone call, I couldn't get a beep on my pager. But guess what? I got a job at Marla Gibbs, and she passed the torch. It was the summer that she closed her doors, and she gave us the blessing to take all those children that we were working with, and she was like, start your own thing. Now cut to 22 years later, two of her great grandbabies have been students of mine, and she still comes, she's right there, and I just saw her April 7th, and she said, I know why I told you to do this. She said, sometimes God gives you the vision. She's like, but he gave me the provision. But she's like, she said she could not do what we were doing with AGC that she was doing with the Vision Theater. So I want to acknowledge Marla Gibbs, number one, for seeing having the provision to pour into us and to give us the inspiration to do something that we were just struggling artists, and we were just, okay, my mother thought I was crazy, and we're going to start a school. Yeah, and we're going to do this, and we did it. We put our hearts, we put our minds together, and we had the community behind us, and there are so many people in this room that have believed in AGC, that have supported, whether you have bought a ticket, you have sponsored a child, you've donated backpacks, or whatever. I thank you, because it truly, truly takes a village, and I thank you all so much. I wanna also thank my auntie, who is in the house, who took me to see The Wiz when I was 9 years old. And I saw Stephanie Mills, and it was The Wiz, and it was the most amazing thing to not only see artists that look like me, but to see a production of that caliber. And I was like, I want to do it. I want to do it. So thank you, Auntie Gail, for being a part of that. I want to thank my mother, who is in the house. Stand up, Mommy. Thank you. Thank you. Who took this girl with dreams, and you took me to every dance class. You took me to every acting class. You supported me when I decided to major in drama at Howard University. Everybody else thought I was crazy, but you believed in me, and you still believe in me to this day. Even when I don't believe in myself, you encouraged me. She picked out this dress, okay? That was my mama. And I was like, okay. I was like, oh, it's Nipsey Blue, okay? So that's my girl. There were so many ways that my life could have gone in so many different directions. Yeah, Nipsey Blue, for real. No, shout out to Lauren London, who I not only worked with, but she's an AGC baby. Yeah, so there are no coincidences. And there are so many ways that my life could have gone growing up on 84th and Western, because they were the A-Trey Gangsta Crips, we had to know them. But every dance class, every acting class, and every possibility, thank you for pouring into me. I want to give a shout out to my two sisters that are here. And me and Janet, we would fight like cats and dogs, because she would always tell on me this, that, and the other, but I thank God you did. Okay? Because I was a handful, I was a lot, I'm not gonna lie. But my sister, thank you, and her name is Janet Perry. So there are no coincidences. Thank you, Jan Perry, for that incredible introduction. Go figure. I'm having that's why I was so nervous backstage, because I was like, oh God, it's too many coincidences. And now my corporate whisperer sister, Jackie, who has stepped in with Amazing Grace Conservatory and has challenged me. Also, in the words of Jackie Castillo, they'll say no, but guess what? It'll be not right now. You keep me woke. You keep me pushing forward when I'm afraid to ask, because I always hide behind, and it is hard to do the ask. But I thank you for pouring into me. I want to thank the young people that performed today. Are they still here? Are my students still here? Stand up, babies. Give these babies a round of applause. Stand up, Zoe. Thank you so much. Thank you. Because we're in the middle of production for our West Side Story. Yes, a shameless plug, but they took time out of rehearsing for that, because we're serious in our rehearsals, and we put this together for something that was so special that I didn't know it was going to anoint my life the way that it has. And also, in keeping in line with the Torch Awards, this is the first year out of 22 years. We do 3 shows a year. You do the math, and we also do outside appearances. So we've done over 70 productions, but this is the first year that we've come full circle, and now we've passed the torch, and I have 2 alumni that are directing the show. I have, yes, that's major. And I have one of my alumni that is the stage manager for this show, and now they are teaching us new things that, wow, it just doesn't stop. So I'm just so honored I hate to be long-winded, but I got to give thanks where it is due. And most importantly, I want to thank the Legacy Ladies for the work that you do, because it is so needed, it is so valued, and it makes a difference, because this baby right here, she was like, you got this. Thank you. Thank you, Thamar. Thank you all so much. Thank you for this honor. Thank you.
On behalf of Legacy Ladies, we'd like to present this to the Scholarship for the Children.
Like me, who need glasses, that's $2,500 going to that fantastic organization. The check was big, but I know everyone couldn't see it. All right. Thank you to all the honorees for making such a huge difference in the lives of these young women. Now, we'd like to ask the president, Lady Jackie, to please return to the stage. Lady Jackie.
Again, I want to take this opportunity to acknowledge another special person. This person has been with us for about 15 years, but I need the assistance of my assistant. Mariah Moore, will you please come out? She has this title, ATP, Assistant to the President. She loves it. Mariah, where are you? She's failing me now, though. There she is. She's so sweet. Okay, so she has something. So at this point, I'd like somebody special to come on stage. He wasn't expecting this, but Chris Schauble, come on up here. Come on up here, Chris. Yeah, right. Okay, so anyway, I just want to thank Chris on behalf of Legacy Ladies for being with us for 15 years. He's been very committed and faithful. His wife, Katrina, was one of the original Legacy Ladies that helped us to get this organization started. But of course, she had twins and more kids on top of that. So that just kind of inhibited her.
Yeah, two sets of twins.
Okay, we got it, Chris. We got it. And so that just kind of inhibited her from participating to the level that she wanted to. So we are just so thankful to you, Chris, for those two sets of twins. And so so we've been really happy. And we do have a little presentation for him this evening. Mariah, do you have it? She's checking right now. Yes, nice little music. Thank you so much, Alon. I appreciate that. Just a little pause in the schedule here. You're like, what is it? Yeah, okay. Okay. So, Chris, on behalf of Legacy Ladies, you are the man with the mic. And you are half of what we do. You make us who we are. You're very successful in telling our story. And we really do appreciate everything that you've done for us. And this is just a small token of our appreciation. We give you the mic tonight. Thank you. So from the schoolhouse to the White House, Leadership Academy has been very effective for our after-school program for high school girls at Washington Prep, King Drew, Dorsey High School, Crenshaw, and even our elementary school, Angeles Mesa Elementary School. They are affectionately called torchettes because we expect them to continue to keep the torch burning with a passion for service to our community, focused on leadership. At this time, I would like to introduce to you our graduating class of the Schoolhouse to the White House Leadership Academy. And unfortunately, about half our girls are not here this evening. There's been some, quite a few of them had some challenges in the last couple of months. But those who are here, we're very proud of them. So I'd like for them to please come forward, and you can hold your applause till the end. We have Alaysia, Virgil, Ashley Harris, Jalen Anderson, Kaylin Campbell, Malia Williams, Mariah Moore, Maya Mullen, Sarah Jato, Symphony Bordenave, Thamar Scipio, Toy Carter, and Yanai Reynolds. Let's give them a round of applause.
This girl is on fire! This girl is on fire! She's walking on fire! This girl is on fire!
Looks like
so these young ladies, they have volunteered over 500 hours of community service while maintaining a GPA of at least 3.4. They will continue a legacy of service, and they're going to pass it forward. Please turn your attention to the monitors and see the journey of our Torchettes this year.
Nipsey, what do you think is the legacy that he left for all of you? Sarah.
Start creating your own businesses and innovating for your community. Mm-hmm. So, you know, I know here at Dorsey, there's a lot of males who are interested in the entertainment industry. I know one who owns his own company right now. So I think he's definitely impacted the minds of younger people in the business aspect. Mm-hmm. Like, creating your own for your own, including your own, hiring your own. So, yeah.
Hello, I am Dr. Deshelle Bird, principal of George Washington Preparatory High School, and I am so excited to be celebrating the 15 wonderful years that Legacy Ladies have worked with Washington Prep. Thank you, Lady Jackie, for your vision and bringing this program to Washington Prep. It has served hundreds of my girls and have given them exposure and opportunities of a lifetime. Your dedication along with the other Legacy Ladies have given the Torchettes experiences that are meaningful that will help them develop into positive women in the community. You have taken these young ladies into new arenas and have built their leadership skills where they are capable of doing any and everything. Some of my alumni Torchettes have come back and created programs and conferences and modeled the various behaviors that you and the Legacy Ladies have taught them. I am eternally grateful for even being honored at a previous Torch Award for the skills and commitment that I have to this program. It is something that is worthwhile and very meaningful to all of our young ladies. Thank you so much, Lady Jackie, and all of the Legacy Ladies and the sponsors and everyone who has ever contributed to making this program happen for the students of Washington Preparatory High School.
Like I said, there's room for everybody to exist individually. You don't have to be necessarily what you see. You can have mentors. You can have people that can guide you through, you know, decisions with finances and, you know, branding, if you will. But at the end of the day, you know where you want to exist.
Hi, my name is Sarah Jato. I am a sophomore that attends Dorsey High School, and I am 15 years old. This program has molded me into a lady. I am growing up with three brothers currently, and being in a household full of men, I hadn't really known anything of a mother figure besides my mother and Michelle Obama. So coming into this program and being surrounded by women who look like me, who think like me, for the least, has been really comforting. And for the 15th anniversary, I'd be surrounded by more people that appreciate figures like Lady Jackie, people that uplift the program, and I'd be a part of this movement of this new generation that is to come. And so I want to thank Lady Jackie and all of Legacy Ladies, those who are a part of it, for helping me become one of them, accepting me in any way, shape, or form, and teaching me about what I want to become. And so I'm so glad that I'm a part of this program, and I deeply appreciate it.
Greetings, Emily Williams here, principal of Angeles Mesa Elementary and Dreams Magnet, with a happy 15th anniversary of the Torch Awards to Legacy Ladies. We are so proud to partner with you and make the world a better place, especially for our young ladies. This year, with record numbers of women in Congress, and with Kamala Harris announcing her candidacy for the president, we are poised to break that glass ceiling, and with Legacy Ladies offering our girls a safe place to discard their armor, show up, be seen, and be heard. Who knows, one day, maybe, Angeles Mesa will be in the White House because one of our girls, women, is there. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Nikayla, and I'm 8 years old in third grade, and I go to Angeles Mesa.
Hello, my name is Anaya. I'm in fourth grade. I'm 10 years old, and I go to Angeles Mesa. Congratulations on your 15th year of Legacy Ladies.
And congratulations for teaching us and taking the time to teach us how to be a lady.
Was 100% and not 76.4%. What if African American girls had an opportunity for secondary education just based upon their intellect and not on their heritage or lineage or bank account? What if African American girls or youth did not continue to have the lowest test scores? What if the educational gap did not exist? What would this world be like for African American girls if they were left behind? What if they received a quality education and they didn't have to take non-credited remedial classes their first year of college just to get to the grade level like 60% of African Americans do. What if? Well, I can only imagine. Imagine a time when this world would be like those roadblocks, didn't even exist. Imagine a time when children in our community are not approached by drug dealers, human traffickers, or gang members, because that's what happens when they go to school and when school is out. Someday that will change. Imagine a world when Imagine a world when, after graduating from college, our girls are voted into political office. Their decisions would change our world. They would fund schools so students have the resources they need to excel in college. They would lower the crime rate because they have experienced the social ills in their community. They would make college affordable for all, and they would support the homeless and the helpless. Someday, just imagine, if they had an opportunity to use their voice to advance their community, someday. Imagine a time when they aren't stereotyped because of their zip code or how they pronounce their name. I can only imagine. But there is hope. Thanks to all of you, the world I am describing is getting closer to becoming a reality for our Torchettes. Because they will have a voice. They are resilient. They will have higher test scores. They are unstoppable. They will close the educational gap. They will adapt and they will create. They will not fall victim to the ongoing disparities. They will be in the White House, yes they will, and they will change the world, yes. They are the future. These young ladies are the future. But it will always be challenging because racism and classism are alive. But just like our ancestors, they keep coming because they are more than conquerors. They keep coming because they are resilient. They keep coming because they are strong. That day is coming. But they must not become complacent with the status quo. They will still have to fight for what they want. We hope their world does not end at the admissions office. So I look to all of you continually help our village and commit to modeling a healthy lifestyle. Provide emotional support. Expose them to life experiences that would build character and grit. We are working tirelessly to build a financial safety net, and we are counting on you. Will you join us? On stage with me are our graduating seniors. They have worked hard, and this is their final year. And you're going to hear their reflections in just a few minutes, but please turn your attention to the monitors to see their activity in their senior year.
Thank you. We went to Washington, D.C., and that's the final leg of this program. Once they've been in the program at least 3 years, then they are rewarded with a trip to Washington, D.C., and the other girls, the undergraduates that you saw this year, they went to San Francisco, and we just had a great time. And so they've been exposed to a lot of things from coast to coast. But so you can get to know them a little bit better, I'd like for them to introduce themselves to you, and they can tell you what school they go to, what grade they're in, and what they plan to major in, or if your college has been accepted. I'll start with you, Alaysia.
Hello. Okay. My name is Alaysia Virgil. I go to Washington Preparatory High School. I'm in the 12th grade, and I have been admitted to Sacramento State. And I will either be majoring in criminology or psychology.
Hi, everyone. Excuse the high voice. You know, it's a little pitchy in here. My name is Kaylin Campbell. I am a graduating senior at Crenshaw High School, and I will be attending the University of San Diego State, and and my major will be chemistry.
Oh. My name is Malia Williams. I attend Dorsey High School. I'm also in 12th grade. The college I will be attending to will be Dominguez Hills with a major of biology pre-med and a minor of business marketing. I hope to become a surgeon one day.
Hello, everyone. My name is Mariah Moore. I'm a senior at Crenshaw High School. I have 14 college acceptances, but I've chosen Dillard University. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you. I've chosen to attend Dillard University, where I will major in mathematics and business administration. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Thamar Scipio. I go to Crenshaw High School. I am a senior, and I will be attending UCLA in the fall. And I will be majoring in human anatomy or human physiology.
Hi, my name is Toy Carter. I'm a senior at Dorsey High School. I'm undecided on which college I'm going to, but I will be majoring in nursing.
Okay, so let's find out a little bit more about you. Since you've been in this program, what has been most memorable for you, and how many years have you been in the program? Toy.
Okay. I've been in the program for 4 years, and the most memorable thing about it is the Torch Awards, because you get to network and meet so many new people that are that have already achieved the dream that you want to be in.
I've been in this program for 4 years, and the most memorable part was going to D.C. because, you know, I haven't been there in a long time. And it was great to see all the sites and where history was born at.
Hello, I've been in the program for 4 years, and my most memorable experience in Legacy Ladies is going to different events with Lady Jackie, where I get to meet people with a variety of different careers, possible mentors, and internships.
For me, the most memorable was when Lady Jackie actually connected me with a cardiothoracic surgeon, because that was one of the type of specialties I was considering. And what I learned was like the transition from college to going to medical school. And it was awesome because I was able to watch surgeries.
My most memorable in the program would also have to be the Torch Awards, because each year it just gets like more consecutive and more people show up. And, you know, not saying that, you know, we don't get any people like that. It's just I get to meet more people. Like, before, I used to just sit in the back and just observe and be like, okay, you know, she looked good. You know, I like her heels. I like her hair. But now I get to actually walk up to people and be like, oh my gosh, your hair is so nice. And, you know, just network. And it was just like a really good experience.
Okay, so I'd like for you to finish this sentence for me. When I go off to college, I cannot live without.
Mm-hmm.
No, whoever wants to answer.
When I go to college, something I cannot live without is prayer. I would not be where I am today without the prayers of the people who love and support me.
Amen. Amen. Anyone else? Go.
What was the question again?
When you go off to college, what is something that you cannot live without?
I can't live without support from within my school, my family, and Legacy Ladies since I've been in the program.
Malia?
For me, it would be family because I'm doing this for my family, and when I make big money from being a surgeon, then I do plan to do stuff for my family and, you know, pay them back for everything that they've done for me.
So what advice would you give future Torchettes that are coming into this program? Toy?
I would just say stay focused on the path. Stay in this program because Lady Jackie always has something up her sleeve that will, you know, take you somewhere further than where you thought you were going to be. So just stay in this program.
What Toy said, and also stay open-minded and always take advantage of all opportunities because you never know what you will discover about yourself. So yeah, that's pretty much.
The advice I would give to the future Torchettes is to be very observant, to watch the people who are around you, and through that, you decide who you want to be and what you want to do with your life.
Wow. Okay, I have one last question. You know, I've seen how all of you have evolved over the years, and where you are today is a totally different person than where you were when you were in the ninth grade. So tell me, how do you feel that you have changed all this time in the last 4 years? Okay, Thamar is a burning thought there.
Before, like, ninth grade, I thought I had high school all figured out. If I could talk to myself, you don't have high school figured out. It's not a breeze like you think it is. Make sure you do what you love. Make sure you stay focused, because if you don't do what you love and if you're just here to please everyone else, you're going to be lost. You're not going to have any sense of individuality. You're going to stress yourself out trying to please everyone else. So what you need to do is do what you love, do what's best for you. And you don't have it all figured out.
I would tell my ninth grade self to just really listen and just pay attention to things. Because when I was in ninth grade, I would just listen to myself. I wouldn't listen to anybody else because I was just like, who's going to tell me better than me? Like, I got my best opinion. But I've learned that it helps to have... I'm serious. Like, you know... But I've learned to listen to other people's opinions, because other people do have their best interests in heart for you, and to just have other people's support just there for you is just like a really big thing to have. So yeah.
Okay, does anybody else want the mic at this point? Okay, Mariah.
I would tell 14-year-old Mariah to not be so shy. To shine like you know how, and shine like you know how, because that's what sets you aside from everyone else in the room.
Yeah. Well, Torchettes, thank you so much for those comments. You know, we're really going to miss you, and I'm really going to miss you. You know, you've been with me for 4 years, so it's been great. So I think the Legacy Ladies have something for you. Ladies, will you come to the stage, please? Okay. Ladies Betty, Lady Andrea, what do we have? Someone tell us what we have.
We have laptops for all the girls.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Well, you have made us so proud. You really have, and you deserve everything that you're going to get now and in the future. And I know you're going to work really hard for achieving your goal, but I think we have something else for you. Ladies, do we have something else? Yes, we do. Drum roll. So we have a check that will be disseminated among you ladies for $20,000. So that is a wrap. That ends 15 years. We thank you all so very much. And now it's time to party.
Let's dance, everybody. Yes. Come on.
Let's get on the dance floor.
Michelle Pfeiffer, that white coat. This one for them good girls, them good girls. Straight past the beat. Smiling, wilding, living it up in the city. I got shirts on with St. Laurent. God, the kid was there. I'm so pretty. I'm too hot. Call the police and the fire man. I'm too hot. Get the dragon for a rejection man.